Kampala Capital City and Metropolitan Affairs Minister Hajjat Mensah Kabanda yesterday revealed that the government has finally resolved on where to dump garbage from the Kampala and the Metropolitan area. Speaking from her office in Kampala, Mensah Kabanda revealed the outcomes of the meeting that was held with the first Deputy Prime Minister in Kampala yesterday on the issues of garbage disposal. The minister announced a shift from Mkumba dumping site, citing health reasons it would cause among other challenges. Among places that would have been highlighted for short-term garbage dumping is Mukono and Nansana.
We have resolved that in the meantime we can dump in Mukono because we can no longer dump in Entebbe. One thing, the place in Entebbe is narrow and depending on the environment there, we always carry 2,500 tons a day, which is not accommodative to Entebbe.
Kabanda, however, revealed that the government is working out on a long-term plan for garbage disposal for Kampala and the metropolitan area.
We are going to do some renovations there, the roads and the dumping site itself. And I know the Minister of Works has started immediately to do the renovations on the road. So that means after some few days, we are going to shift to Nansana. But we have a longer term.
The minister, who acknowledged the challenge of garbage buildup in the city, further urged the public to be patient as the government paves way for a lasting solution. The High Court sitting, presided over by Justice Isaac Mwata, continued yesterday in hearing the case involving the murder of a renowned city businessman, Henry Katanga. Yesterday, the court heard the testimony of Dr. Richard Ambayo, a pathologist at the Mulago City mortuary, who revealed that the gunshot that claimed the life of Henry Katanga was fired at close range, likely with the weapon pressed directly against his head.
Continued further through the mid-breath to the right temporal brain lobe, causing extensive brain laceration and contusion.
The defense lawyers cross-examined Dr. Richard Ambayo to ensure the consistency of his testimony.
Would I also be correct to say that a forensic postmortem is from a branch of medical science called forensic pathology?
Ambayo, who is the seventh witness, stated that the lack of blackening around the entry wound suggests the gun was in direct contact with the skin when it was fired. This, he says, is consistent with close-range shot. Dr. Ambayo's testimony is central to the ongoing trial in which Molly Katanga, the widow of the deceased, stands accused of his murder, alongside her daughters Patricia Kakwanza and Martha Nkwanzi, as well as George Amanyire, a shamba boy, and Charles Otai, a nursing officer. All have pleaded not guilty to the charges. Doctors in India's eastern city of Kolkata yesterday held a protest calling for justice for a colleague who was raped and murdered at a local hospital. The demonstrators marched down the street chanting slogans and holding placards as they continued their strike for the 13th day. Thousands of outraged Indian protesters, including arch-rival football fans and lawyers, called for justice since Monday after the rape and murder of a doctor, as widespread strikes by healthcare workers entered a second week. A discovery of the 31-year-old doctor's bloodied body at a state-run hospital in the eastern city of Kolkata on August 9th sparked medical strikes and protests across India, channeling anger at the chronic issue of violence against women. Doctor associations from government-run hospitals in many cities across India continue to strike since Monday that cut non-essential services. An autopsy confirmed sexual assault, and in a petition to the Kolkata High Court, her parents said they suspected that daughter was gang-raped.